Thank you again. Thank you for your patience. As I said, the seven strings, the 13 resonating, they have their moods, just like you and me. So we have changed from one mood, Rag Kirwani, to another rag that I have chosen. I'm coming to it. Indian classical music is a connection to nature from within. We try to feel what is without and internalize it. It is a path of devotion from simple memorized compositions for years and years, and the dadiri that you heard, the gamakas, the mir, all these day to day, just like meditation. So music is meditation, all music is. And sitar, as beautiful as it looks, is very unforgiving. You have to really cut your fingers, bleed, cry, whine, and then only a saw will sound like a saw. So today I have chosen rag Megh. Megh means cloud. And it also symbolizes the inspiration of nature. It itself says so much that a rag is named cloud. We have named rags like Basant, which is spring. So it is so connected. This names of the ragas itself tells you that the composition is actually out there. And all we have to do is make it accessible in human form. So we have chosen the melodies and we have created these feelings. Whatever we feel by seeing something, we want to say something in melody. So that's how the rags are composed. And to me, as a visual artist and a musician, it is not separate, especially watercolor. In Indian classical music, I decide something, but something else happens. I am not in control. It is the music is the medium, and I am just following the medium, which takes me somewhere and takes me to unknown realms which I have never found before. Every time I play something, I'll go somewhere else. I didn't know. I'm again searching. And then again, the next time I play the same rag, it's going to tell me something else about the clouds. So rag Megh, I'm going to present first in a solo alap, which is called the introduction, which is the heart of the rag. I'm going to play a short alap because we do want to have the exciting, you know, accompaniment of Nitin, of course, and time is short. And then I'm going to go as we go along, and I hope you and I travel all along together to feel the clouds. And before I start, I must say that I have my student Ari Naiman in Tanpura. So I'm happy that you're here, and we shall start and with rag Megh. Thank you. You can move it a little back.
Thank you. Thank you.
So that was clouds in many forms, the soft, the medium, the strong, the soft, everything together. Thank you so much, Nitin, for your wonderful accompaniment. So I actually have chosen two other forms of Indian classical music that I'll depict. This was a traditional sitar presentation with tintal or a slower composition than a fast, and jhala, which is a very typical of the instrumental presentation of India. And now I have chosen a romantic tumri. Tumri means a semi-classical form of poetic rendition of a melody based on a rag. So all of these are based on rags. And after the tumri, I will also present to you a tarana, which is a bhajan actually, a Krishna bhajan. Bata chalata. It is a Krishna bhajan in tintal. So I'm trying to share with you the beauty of Indian classical music as much as possible in this short window. I hope you'll enjoy. And traditionally also, Bhairavi is the last rag that is presented in a concert. So this, all the tumri and the bhajan, which is a tarana also, it will be presented in Bhairavi. Thank you. Has requested me to actually sing the melody so that you can sync with. It is a it is a Nazrul composition which talks about the bird is swinging the bough too much, the buds have not blossomed yet. So the poet is asking the bird not to sway the bough so frequently. Let be patient. Spring is just around the corner. Let the buds bloom, and then we will rejoice. It's in Bhairavi again.
Bagichae bulbule tui phul shakhate tishne aaji dol. Bagichae bulbule tui phul shakhate tishne aaji dol. Thank you.
Thank you. I can't thank you enough for being here and sharing this evening. Thank you to Kennedy Center and its amazing team who made this possible, the sound, everything. And of course, Jeet Kumarji, Anjali, and also Rita, many, many thanks for giving us a chance to perform here. This has been a really, really wonderful experience. Can't thank you enough. And of course, to all volunteers of Sitar Niketan, everyone, my heartiest, heartiest gratefulness. Thank you very much. Thank you. There are some CDs and the other thing, if you want to take some music home, please feel free to. Thank you.